Hello, my name is Kathleen Seneff. Welcome to this edition of GSP TV. Our program will hit the highlights of events at the Governor's Scholar Program here at Morehead State University. We've sent reporters to several locations at MSU to bring you updates on nights filled with entertainment, convocations, and the grocery run featuring scholars rushing to Sloan's, armed with rolling suitcases. We also have footage from the Laramie Project produced by the drama class, a true story brought to life by our very community. The July 4th parade featured scholars in a costume, and they discovered their creative side by exploring Community Arts Day activities. And we've got sports, the tennis tournament, and a taste of the weather here in Morehead. But today's first story features Jake Ryle reporting on the grocery run.
Scholars, this is Jake Ryle reporting for their journalism class, and we're here at the first grocery day of the year. And as you can see, we have a lot of grocery people lined up, ready to go. All right, GSPers, I am outside of Sloan Supermarket right now, where about dozens of GSPers are trying to get their groceries for that quick little grocery run that they have every week. And right now I'm with Ryan Frazier from Louisville Mail.
Hey.
And I have one question for you. What are you coming to Sloan Supermarket to get?
Oh, duct tape, lunch meat, toilet paper, bread, t-shirts, and fabric with my best friend, Ed.
Hi, I'm Alyssa Story, and I'm the fourth floor RA in Menon Tower. I know all my girls are loading up on some toilet paper, which I'm glad to see.
GSP students crammed the aisles as they overran Sloan's grocery store, leaving innocent shoppers to wonder if suitcases were on sale. Scholars crammed their carts with everything from toilet paper to dairy products, personal hygiene to poultry. The crowd may look bad, but the checkout line is worse. This is Jake Ryle reporting from Sloan's.
And that was Jake Ryle reporting on the grocery run. Hello, I'm Nicole Nolan, and this is GSP TV. Our next story takes us to Community Arts Day, where one of our staffers has some footage that shows us the artsy side of GSP.
Today, scholars have been tie-dyeing various items from t-shirts to socks, and they've been gathered around Menon Tower around about 7 buckets of different colored dye, and their work has turned out very nice. Now we're here with Jordan Wilkinson outside the tie-dye station, and we're going to ask Jordan a few questions about why he chose to dye today. Jordan, what article did you choose to dye today?
Oh, I chose my cross-country t-shirt from back home, so.
Any reason why you chose that shirt?
I accidentally wore it while I was tie-dyeing and got stuff on it, so I just decided to redo it.
It's a pretty good reason. I see you chose blue. Any reason?
No, just try to keep it with the school colors, so.
This was a unique activity for scholars to explore. Community Arts Day gave a delightful twist to an unusual bland Sunday afternoon.
Thanks, Whitney. This is Shelby Cheney reporting for GSP TV. Our next story takes us to a convocation with Nick Clooney.
Hi, Mr. Clooney.
Whitney, good to be with you.
Thank you. What would you say is the most important thing young people can do to help the situation in Darfur right now?
Raise heck. Be a pest. Get out there. Talk to all of the people that you could possibly talk to. People in power. Anybody. Whether it's newspapers, whether it's television, whether it's radio, whether it's politics. Talk to them. Tell them they're not doing enough. Tell them to get off their duffs. Tell them to help the people in Darfur. And if they don't, people are dying today. Nearly a half million have died already.
Hi, I'm here with Zach Russell right after our convocation with Nick Clooney. Zach, what did you think the most important thing that Nick talked about today was?
Well, Whitney, I'm afraid that's very hard to say. He discussed a lot of very important issues to the students and everything. Again, the main subject was about the Darfur incident that he mentioned. I think he said a lot of good things and mentioned many different topics, which I don't believe the students or even myself knew about, such as the African Union with their part in the role, and even the European Union. So, and even China's relationship with the Sudan in terms of oil. So I think a lot of those things were very key in helping us understand maybe what we could do and just learn about the situation so far.
Thank you for that footage, Whitney. Now we're going to take a look at our very first showcase, where scholars exhibited their many talents through drama, dance, skits, and song.
As the lights dimmed in Button Auditorium on June 29th, 2007, the song Shake exploded out of the speakers. Rebecca Deary, Emily Mooney, and Katie Heron took the stage to perform a very upbeat hip-hop dance. The crowd began to move along with them. The showcase had officially began. As the performances continued, much more talent was revealed. But as the showcase ended with Michael Wynn and Adam Orr singing an acoustic and different version of Daughters by John Mayer.
You can't have the newscast without the weather. Here's our forecast with Greg Reynolds.
Hi, this is Greg Reynolds here with GSP TV weather update. As you can see today, from border to border, it's sunny and dry. But now let's take a closer look at Morehead.
It's a beautiful day.
Now back to the anchor desk.
Thankfully, however, the weather for the tennis tournament was almost perfect. Jake Ryle ran over from Sloan's just in time to bring us this footage.
Thank you for tuning in to GSP TV. We have a special live coverage. My name is Jake Ryle, and we're here at the tennis tournament where we've got four teams actually playing right now. And we're going to bring you live coverage, including interviews, and everybody from RAs to students are here right now, so we'll just bring you everything we can.
The tennis tournament took place despite the heat and wind. GSP's annual tennis matches were organized by Mark Helton with help from Brian Belva. The finals featured an exciting match between Tessa White teamed with Jordan Fitch and Matt McGrail with Mallory Garrison. The action was fast and furious, but in the end, Matt and Mallory triumphed in the hard-fought match. Here with Matt McGrail from Henderson County High School, and I understand that you've just played two games and you've won both matches 6-0. I understand that's pretty good job.
We did all right, yeah.
Just tell me a little bit about the games. How did you like? How were they?
Well, I mean, I'm hitting all right. We didn't really have to, you know, play, you know, like super hard. I mean, it wasn't like Wimbledon or anything. Right. We're just out here having fun and playing some tennis, and we hope to do well after dinner. That's where we're headed right now.
Heading to dinner, right? I understand the wind has been playing an issue with some of the players. Has it picked up lately, or, I mean, what's your take on that?
Well, it's picked up a little bit in the last half hour or so, but that doesn't affect me at all because where our high school's courts are laid out, the courts are just sitting there on a plane with nothing to break the wind at all, and the wind whips there about 45 and 50 miles an hour, like as on a regular day, you know, on a regular clear day. And so this is nothing. This is no big deal at all.
All right.
Thanks again, Jake. And now for our last program, we're going to take a look at some of the highlights of GSP, put together on a slideshow with music by our GSP TV editors.
Over, let's pack up and start again. 20 days on the road, just left Port Dover with 16 days to go. I just called my mom to tell her that I miss her. Just wrote my girl, man, I can't remember the last time I kissed her. Soon I'll be at home with all my friends. After 36 days on the road, lights go down, the noise is faded. We leave this town anticipated. Soon we'll be back on the road again. But not forgotten, one by one, the fights we fought in. Soon we'll be back on the road again for 36 days.